going on, YouTube? It's your boy, Mr. Random. Hey, is that loud? Oh, yeah, it is.
All right, guys, now what does this Mustang and this Crown Victoria have in common? Well, that is, they were both made in 2011. Okay, well, technically this is a 2004 Crown Victoria, and although the last Crown Vic rolled off the assembly line in 2012, it's had this particular body style, both exterior and interior, since 1998. That is 22 years, folks. So, why do I have this Mustang parked next to it? Well, that's because in 1998, the Mustang looked something like this. In 1999, it looked something like this. There's also 2005. And then last but not least, the 2010 and up generation. So what I'm trying to say, guys, is that for 22 years, the Mustang has gone through four completely different body changes and upgrades, yet this car right here, this boat, has remained untouched for 22 years. This car is the embodiment of, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. And it's the true, in my opinion at least, man, this is the true definition of built Ford tough. But like I mentioned in my last video, it's getting harder and harder to find a Crown Victoria P71 that hasn't been completely trashed and abused or isn't at the end of its life. And with more and more departments retiring these old dogs literally on a daily basis, hell, even the California Highway Patrol actually retired its last Vic about 3 days ago with 110,000 miles. Prices are only going to start getting higher for a good example of one of these. Gone soon will be the days of young drivers buying these as their starter cars, or someone that's on a budget who just needs a decent daily driver. That's because the middle ground market for these cars is slowly disappearing. Now, what the hell am I talking about middle ground? Well, more and more, if you go on Marketplace or Craigslist or anything else, there's really only just two examples of these cars. They're either completely beat to hell, or the ones that are in really, really good condition are expensive as hell. The middle ground one, those good $2,000 Crown Victorias that still had relatively low miles and were still relatively reliable, those days are slowly going away. And here's why. The fact that people are using these cars as derby cars and just running them completely into the ground is putting us Crown Vic enthusiasts in a horrible position. Many of us might be saying, well, what about the civilian Crown Vics like the LX or even the other Panther cars like the Grand Marquis? Sure, there's still plenty of those around, but like a Cobra badge on a Mustang or an SS badge on a Chevy, sure, many people clone them, but deep down, they will never be the original. I've noticed an ironic thing about the Crown Victoria P71 Police Interceptor. It's going the way of the 90s Impala SS. I foresee in the very, and I mean very near future, a scenario where, much like the Impala SS, where you now have to verify the 8th digit on the VIN code to make sure it's a true SS, the same will be happening with the Crown Vics. Those three digits, P71, will mean something. They will hold value, and nothing can take its place. So if you're watching this and own an old true P71 Interceptor, you should rethink before you just junk it. At this point, it's paying off to spend the extra grand or two to replace the engine or transmission. Because one day, one of these will be sitting in an abandoned farm, inside a barn, a true P71, fully equipped, armed to the teeth, ready to be restored. Ladies and gentlemen, you are looking at the last of the true V8 police interceptors, a car that will captivate, intimidate, and fascinate drivers of all ages for many years to come.